That was a nice introduction. Thank you, John. And what about AdExchanger, man? This is an organization that has changed so much. John, when John talks about the first days, I mean, I remember him walking into our offices when we were four of us in an office. He was one guy writing a blog, and neither of us had shoes that needed to be polished, if you know what I mean. Thank you guys all for spending a few minutes with us this morning. This is day two, so I assume everybody here is here either because A, they love ag tech so much they didn't want to miss day two, or B, they couldn't get a flight out because of all the inauguration traffic. Based on all the fake news I read, I guess it's A. You guys must love ad tech. So this morning, I'm going to talk a little bit about how marketing is changing to be less reactive and trying to make changes based on kind of responses that aren't in real time to really being predictable. So although this conversation was really originally titled Marketing at the Speed of Now, what we're really going to talk about today is marketing at the speed of next. And I believe Nielsen, and particularly Nielsen Marketing Cloud, is uniquely positioned to take advantage of determining what's next. So if we can cue the video.
What's next is always being put in front of us.
Next station.
Next!
Next time.
You can either run from what's next, or you can become what's next.
Man, you're next.
You can create the next video that will set the internet on fire. You can invent the next product that will change the world. You can redefine your industry or create a new one. But to pull that off, you gotta understand people. Real people in the real world.
Coming up next.
So you're gonna need real data. Data you can use. Data you can trust. Data backed by real science. When you have that kind of data, you'll not only see what's next, you'll get there first. So, the next time the world asks what's next, you have the answer.
Wow, how is that? Does that get you excited to market? Okay, boy. You guys, I'm flat today. Come on, how about some laughs here, something? Look, marketing at the speed of next, it's a great buzzword. It sounds really interesting. But what does it mean? What does it mean to try to market next? Well, I've tried to break it down to kind of four key aspects of what the modern marketer needs to do to market at the speed of next. And they really focus on four things. The idea of anticipating shifts in demand. So not just reacting to shifts, but being able to predict what they are. To be able to act on that immediately. So I know what's going to happen. What do I do now? And how do I do that? To analyze what's actually happened, and then adapt in real time. These four key things are what can enable a marketer to not just survive in these challenging times, but really thrive and actually get ahead of their competition. So I'm gonna talk a little bit about all of these things and what it takes to deliver against those four A's. So in between your Facebook, your Snapchat, your flights to Canada to get the hell out of here, I will talk about some real things here and what's happening today. Before I do that, I'm going to take 1 second. You saw the video and you saw us talking about the new Nielsen. The elephant in the room here is really thinking about, isn't this what you guys are? Isn't this Nielsen? We know you guys from paper diaries and counting bean cans on shelves between watch and buy. That was the old Nielsen. Nielsen's a different business today. And really, it's been driven by three key things. It's happened over the last year. Acquisitions, partnerships, and big data. And while a lot of our competition has really been focusing on retreading their old technology, marching out marketing reports about market research tech processes that are dead, we've been building an entirely different business through acquisition, partnerships, and big data. On the acquisition front, just take a look at the last 4 years. Literally billions of dollars spent on companies that are moving the needle, changing Nielsen as an entity, but changing our perception and how we touch consumers and marketers around the world. Everyone from companies like Affinova on product research side, to my company, Exalate, in 2015, to people like Point Logic on the media planning side of the business, software, technology, data businesses that have transformed us. We've carried partnerships. Nielsen's always seen as a big company, but relatively insular. That's different. In the marketing cloud alone, we have over 300 ecosystem partners. Everyone's from DSP to RPD. And you may have seen this week, AT&T just signed a deal with Nielsen to provide return path data for measurement. So we're touching more and more different types of people out there. And finally, data. We're not a small data company, we're a big data company. In the marketing cloud alone, we manage 6.5 trillion consumer actions each month that we see. That's equal to about 250 petabytes of data. Big numbers. What does that actually mean? Think of it this way. 50 petabytes of data is the entire work of all published literature in every language since the beginning of time. We are processing 5 times of that each month. So hopefully that little break was enough to convince you that what I'm going to say over the next 10 minutes actually has some merit, has some credit, because Nielsen is a different business and we're able to move at the speed of next. We've changed. Why we've changed is our clients have changed. And these are some stats I'm sure you've seen, but they're great to hammer home. 1970, people saw about 300 ads a day. And mostly they saw them on TV, heard them on the way to work on the radio. Today, 5,000 ads a day. As a marketer, it's hard to break through that. As a measurement company, it's even harder. Think of it this way. On one device, an average consumer looks at their phone, just like you guys are right now, 150 to 200 times a day. Multiply that times the number of smartphones in the country, and you've got 30 billion mobile interactions each day. Those need to be measured, they need to be monetized, they need to be tracked if you're gonna act at the speed of next. So, next is now, and Nielsen's delivering on the promise of next being now. So to anticipate and act, to analyze and adapt, what do you need? What tools are required? 3 key things. Data, technology, and analytics. Very few players out there will be able to deliver that to marketers. Nielsen can. Talk a little bit about each one of those. On data, what does data need to be? We talk about it all the time. Look at 3 criteria around data. It needs to be smart, free-flowing, and at scale. By smart, we mean accurate. It needs to be calibrated. There's lots of data out there. But as you know, garbage in, garbage out. Data has to be accurate. Accuracy is most easily judged by being able to have a gold standard panel or a panel of truth. Nielsen's panel has been the gold standard for literally over 50 years, and that continues to be the case. Data needs to be free-flowing. That means it needs to have the ability to move from application to application without constraints. It needs to be able to move from platform to platform, in and out of walled gardens, to fuel other types of solutions. If data doesn't move, it's not valuable to a marketer. A marketer doesn't want one view of a consumer, it wants a view of a consumer across all platforms. And finally, data needs to be at scale. You'll hear a lot about first-party data as being the golden ticket. First-party data being, you know, amazing. It is. The challenge with first-party data is it doesn't scale. It tells you what you already know about your consumers, and it tells you the consumers you already have. Sure, you want to sell more to those folks, but don't you want to bring more people into the house? So big data, the importance of data means data that is at scale, that tells you different things about your consumers and allows you to expand the first-party data that you have. Second piece of that puzzle, delivering what's next. Technology that's nimble, that's relevant, and that's intelligent. Nimble is not a word that you hear a lot about technology, neither is relevant. But nimbleness is key. Systems need to work with other systems. Applications need to plug into other applications. They need to be flexible. They need to be cloud-based. That's all basic stuff. But what about its ability to work with other partners, to work with third-party applications? If you think about the way stacks are being built today, you constantly hear about vertical integration and consolidation. That's great, but sometimes it doesn't deliver best of breed. The ability to work with great inherent native technologies, as well as plug in other technologies, makes a system nimble. Relevancy. How can technology be relevant? Well, I'll tell you how. Most systems have suites of functions that no one ever touches. What drives relevancy within technology for marketers is the ability to actually have functions that mean something to them. That takes vertical knowledge. So when you look at companies that deliver technology, particularly in the marketing space, look at their ability to understand a vertical. Look at their history with CPG. Look at their understanding of the media space. That means they will deliver technology that's relevant to you, not a cookie cutter that they want to do. So if you build databases, databases are used pretty much by everybody. If you build marketing technology, marketers use that technology, and they want things specific to them. And finally, tech needs to be intelligent. By intelligence, I'll give a little lead to the panel that's coming up next, because there's some folks from IBM on there. It's about AI. And you're going to hear more and more about AI over the coming weeks, months, years, because it's no longer a buzzword, it's real. We're doing this at Nielsen. We're using predictive technology and artificial intelligence to actually build consumer groups and to predict who's going to buy what. This is real, and it's what's next. AI, by 80%, there's a recent survey that said 80% of marketing executives believe that AI is going to change how they fundamentally just talk to their consumers and how they sell products. That's huge. This is real. Finally, and probably the most important part of the triumvirate of delivery of what's next, is analytics. Analytics need to be immediate, adaptive, and actionable. Immediate in the fact that marketers need answers now. They can't wait 6 weeks, 6 days, sometimes even 6 minutes for a response to understand who that consumer is that they're interacting with. It needs to be immediate. Those results need to be adaptive. You need to be able to make change based on those results, and they need to change as well based on information that's coming through. Systems that take data in real time, use AI to change, to adapt those analytics, and that allow you to act on those are systems that are going to be winners. And that's the final piece, the action. If analytics are not actionable, they're worthless. If they're not delivered on a person's level, or on a device level, or on a household level, they're worthless. Aggregated information is the information of yesterday. Information on an individual basis is the data of tomorrow. And being able to act on that individual level, that device level, that household level, is what gives you the ability to deliver what's next. So this is great. Lots of slides, bullets, interesting philosophy. This is real. This is happening today. This is AdExchanger industry preview. This isn't CES. These aren't beta prototypes. This is stuff that's really happening here today. And I'm going to talk for a couple minutes on what that looks like. These are real customers that we've been working with in the marketing cloud over the last several years that have used tech, data, and analytics to deliver superior results by determining what's next. First example I'll share with you is a global CPG company. First stage of this was pulling together data, first-party data that they had on their own, as well as Nielsen Catalina data, which is arguably the largest source of consumer transaction data on the planet. Comes from transactions that on a UPC level that they're able to get on what people are actually purchased. We use that data to actually build custom segments around lapsed buyers, their history, and actually predict who would buy next. We put that data into our DMP and allow that information to then be used to target new audiences and broaden the scope of who that product went after. And artificial intelligence within that system allowed us to not only refine those models and those segments, but actually make them smarter over time. We then analyze the results in real time through multi-touch attribution solution. Through that multi-touch attribution solution, we figured out not only what segments were hitting, but what media was working. The combination of those two results were then fed back into the system in a virtuous cycle and helped us deliver even better results. This created real sales. Not more clicks, not more impressions, not more website visits, but real sales that we were able to measure. As a matter of fact, 2.3 million additional units of product were sold based on this specific campaign and the results that came out of the measurement of that campaign, delivering a 13x ROI. Now, this might seem extraordinary. It's a one-off deal. Because these are cloud-based systems, these are systems. This is not a campaign-based solution. It's a perpetual solution. Because marketing at the speed of next involves a constant flow of data in and out of tool sets. Another case. Something a little closer to home for those of us who either A, like soccer, or B, like to drink beer. And if you don't like either of those two things, I don't know why you're in the ad tech industry. This was Carling in the UK. They were looking to drive additional sales in times when football or soccer season was not occurring. They sell most of their beer during soccer season in the UK, and they were looking to figure out how do we stimulate demand outside of that. Well, through the combination of loyalty card data, which we had through a relationship with Nectar, which is the largest loyalty card data holder in Western Europe, as well as Nielsen data, we're able to find and model lapsed users, so users who had stopped buying because the season was over, and also find new buyers. We used our artificial intelligence layer as well as our DMP to model those users out and to actually activate those users across a huge array of programmatic assets. After that, we looked at, after the delivery, what was the effect of this campaign and determined an actual in-store sales list. So not who we hit and how well we hit them, but actually how well that was sold and how many more units were sold. And again, the results were remarkable. A 20% sales lift of units being sold specifically attributable to the optimization and the predictability of what was next. The ROI was a 4x ROI over the other solutions they had seen. And as a matter of fact, it won the most effective use of data in the UK last year from the Drum Digital Awards. So again, these are things that are happening today. So when we talk about what's next, really next is now at the Nielsen Marketing Cloud. So wrapping up, marketing at the speed of next is about anticipation, it's about acting, and it's about analyzing, but also about adapting tactics in real time. To do so, it takes data, it takes technology, and it takes analytics. Any one of those things is not enough. Stool doesn't stand on two legs, it stands on three. So all of those three things together are what it takes to deliver what's next. And only Nielsen has the science behind what's next. I thank you guys all very much for your time this morning. I hope you have a great rest of the day.